Okay, hello everybody. Thanks for being here. My name is Gulshah. I'm software engineer at Collaborative Productivity almost 3 years. I'm working on Collaborative Office mostly. I'm experienced with interoperability bugs. Today I will talk about how do we proceed when we receive a problematic OOXML document from a customer. First, when we get a problematic file, first of all, I try to reproduce the bug myself. In this process, I check whether missing information is given. If I can't reproduce the bug, I report my own steps to customer and ask what is missing. After that, generally, reported files are complicated and crowded. To focus the problem, I try to simplify documents if it is possible. And for example, the bug can only relate to a table in the document, but there may be additional text, image, objects in the document. In this case, I clean unnecessary objects step by step, and I have to be careful in that stage because some bugs are related with two objects or more complicated. At each step, I check to see if I can still reproduce the bug. And then I inspect the problematic object on UI. Here, I take notes of what caught my attention, and then I read the XML files inside the document. OOXML documents contains mostly compressed XML files. When we use the unzip command, we can see the XMLs as you see at that image. At this stage, I can get more detailed information about the problematic object. And for example, a paragraph element will look like as following. It has more info than UI, as you see. After that, we try to detect problematic part in XMLs. As you can see, OOXML is hard to understand document format than ODF. At this stage, we can get help from OOXML specification to understand which element means what. And now it's time to pick some keywords to and use them in our solution. And now it's time to understand how Collaborative Office handles that problematic object. And for this, we need to collect good keywords from the XMLs. And then we are on the hardest stage, and it is not possible to formulate, unfortunately. And we will grab our keywords, take notes, read the suspected code parts, debug them, and we will do it again and again until we understand what is the problem in the code base. And when we understand the problem once, we will apply our solution ideas one by one, and we will hope they will work. I want to show one real example that I solved before. That's an export bug. You can see details from that link if you are interested in. Problem was, when that we open the file, then save it, then open again, we lost the last part of that text. In first sight, it seems an export bug, but First, I want to understand how that simple text looks like in XAMLs. It was looking like that. For one line, there are four text run: the first, second, third, and fourth. That's normal because the end is bold, as you see, and the other parts has different properties. I select as a keyword, I note the text body and try to understand how it is imported in source code. Then I saw that interesting thing in UI. Playing with UI is important, I think. In sidebar, text has an animation. And before the export code is called, it seems wrong in sidebar. During import, something happened and we lost the last part of the text. When I removed the animation of the text, the bug disappeared. And I was sure about I had to focus on animation. I read the XMLs again and find some keywords to understand how an animation is imported. During the grep, read, and debug session, I found animation mode class handles our animation. At the last stage, I saw interesting value here. You can see a selection as a parameter. During insert into document, create enumeration is called. There is MA selection. Our string has 11 character, but selection value was 8 8. Last three character is missing here. I focus to where that missing selection value comes here. That part is really hard to track, trust me. I took some help from Mike Kagansky. Thanks, Mike, again. At the end, we found set selection function called here, but it was early time to call it. So we just move it at the end of the function and problem is resolved. That's the method that I used while working on interoperability bugs. And that's all from me. Thank you for listening. Is there any question?
Thanks, Gulshan. I think we will be waiting for the Q&A time slot for answering those questions. But thanks.